Ladies and gentlemen, I am Yisrael, and welcome back to the Tale of Fail. Yes, it is the 13th of September, and this was the situation at about 2200 BST. Little bit bad for the new conglomerate, which is awkward because as far as EU Beta 1 is concerned, which is the server that we're going to be on for this episode, I'm kind of playing new conglomerate. So let's just get straight into the fighting. Take an instant action drop pod. You can steer these a little, and it helps because you can generally aim for things like rocky outcrops rather than awkward. Oh, hi there! Of course, people do tend to come and investigate. Consider yourself liberated, Terran scum. Right, let's see what we've got. Couple of random infantry. Rocky outcropping over there is the next dash point. Nothing else except for that mosquito. Alright, well, if he's going to hang around and hover like that, if I can close the range, might be able to set up a shot with a rocket launcher, you never know. Now then, someone apparently was in a hurry to get here just by that bike, but can we get the rocket shot? Can we? Nope! He's been scared off. Now, gunfire inside the building, see a couple of Terrans including a heavy up there. Let's put a grenade through this window and bombs. Oh well, they called this the Tale of Fail. Rather, I call this the Tale of Fail for a fairly good reason. Now I can hear the engineer repairing it. Online. Where's the spawn control gone? There was a little puzzle. Oh right, yeah. That's the new spawn control, ladies and gentlemen. That big reactor-like thingy. Several changes got made recently. The voice announcements for things like spawn control points going on and offline, ditto shield generators, as well as changed graphics. So we no longer have the low-res placeholder console, we instead have that nice new big thing controlling whether or not you can spawn on the site. Something that's bugging me a little, as you can see, I joined up with an outfit on EU Beta 1, is that I don't have the option to just join a squad. Now, maybe because he wasn't squadded up at the time, but it would be nice to have an option that said if an outfit member is in a squad, just go, hey, can I join your squad, mate? It'd make it so much easier just to get grouped up in a hurry. As it is, such things have to be got going. Now, Zervan turned into a fairly major fight this night. However, the new con warp gate was apparently a host of these stand around and look pretty competition. Yeah, best not to go there. We're still trying to find a squad because frankly, if you're not in a squad in this game, you are dead meat. Of course, even if you are in a squad, you're probably going to die anyway, but at least you've got somebody to talk to while you're doing it, and there's the vague hope of teaming up with squad mates and actually making a difference. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, if you aren't squadded, you aren't liberated. Alright, we need a tank. So, welcome to the Vanguard. Fairly typical name, battle tank. Handles very much like tanks in Battlefield, so WASD keys for movement, A and D pitching you left and right respectively most of the time, W and S forward reverse, mouse for turret control, viewpoint control, and I believe it's T to switch to a third person camera. You lose your reticle, but at least you can see what's going on outside. As you can see, field of view is a little more restricted. I will note, however, that the tanks do seem a little weightless at times, as you can see there. For a vehicle that looks like it weighs, what, 50 tons minimum, that flicked up and dropped down without too much weight behind it, but that may just be me. Anyway, onwards we shall go. Let us trundle on. Get to the battle. There were smarter ways of doing this, I know, but I wasn't particularly thinking at the time. I could probably have dropped in one of the closer bases for a start. However, looks like we just need to follow the road, take the second left, and we should wind up at Zervan. Okay. Rolling. Vertical angle isn't too bad on this turret. That was, what, about plus 30 degrees? So you can use this as an improvised anti-aircraft weapon. There is actually a turret fit you can buy that is a dedicated AAA gun and basically turns this thing into an incredibly nasty flak tank. Haven't got it yet on this character. Shall be done. Unfortunately, Auraxium takes a while to accumulate, which of course is the entire point. After all, you're meant to be spending station cash and stuff like that if you're in a hurry. And that spawn controller is broken. So, let's just pivot round and fix this while we're here. Because if the Terrans show up and we can't spawn here, things will be over rather quickly. Right, now, I think, yes, I'm still heavy assault at the moment, so I'm going to need to find an equipment station and reconfigure. Aha, there we go, just drive around there. Now, this is a point that irritates me intensely about reversing in tanks at the moment. ANS normally pivot you left or right. If, however, you are moving backwards, that reverses. A will now start turning the tank to the right, and D will start turning the tank to the left, which can be very, very confusing because Battlefield does it the other way round. Right, gratuitous rock music done. We've got our repair gun. And there we go again! Ugh! I keep expecting A and D to pivot the tank irrespective of how the tank is moving, and it keeps not happening. Something to be fixed. There may well be a switch in the options menu that I've missed, but, oh gods, I'm a moron. Where did we leave that spawn controller? Is it there? No. Aha! Yes, map reading, a skill I must master. Alright. Repair gun armed, finds the smoking remains of the console, and begin the repairs. A long and rather drawn-out process, and it's amazing how much longer it seems to take if there are bullets flying around you at the time. Obviously this is deliberate because losing this particular piece of gear is meant to be a fairly major setback if you're trying to defend your base. You can't spawn there, you're reliant on galaxies and spawn beacons. Another petty irritation to flag for the devs. When you get a turret or a generator, or in this case a spawn control node, back online, because it replaces the item, or rather the wrecked item, with a functioning one, you temporarily lose the lock on your repair gun, so you have to retarget and refire again. Again, this is a petty gripe on my part, but there we go, that's fixed that, and it would be nice if it just carried on fixing it regardless of whether the state changes from active to destroyed or destroyed to active. Actually, how can you fix something that goes from active to destroyed? Ugh, ignore that. Anyhow, right, ooh, lone Terran tank. Come hither. Pop. Right, and he hasn't quite worked out where he's coming from. Oh, now he has. This will be interesting because he has an advantage rate of fire. He also has a cliff in front of him, but we got the first shot, so good night. Right, I think we've got him. Yes, definite lack of people bailing out of tanks there. So we'll just write him off as a corpse. Now then, on to Zervan. Alright, so we need to take the next left by the looks of it. Okay. Take a right here, however. Yes, I fell at navigation too. It wasn't the next left, it was the second left. Hello, fellow liberator of Auraxis. Let us trundle onwards. Aha. Right, I see, so we've got one. Oh, that's armed with rockets, that can be nasty. And they've got three techs, right. Some long range sniping. I'm going to have a little gripe about the NC HUD here. I realise the yellow is stylistic, but I have to observe that. Oh, right, that's one of ours. It does make it very difficult to judge targets when you can barely see your reticle in certain circumstances. Right, let's just patch this up quickly. Remember, of course, ladies and gentlemen, that if you lose a vehicle, particularly the expensive stuff like Vanguards and Galaxies, you have to wait until you can spawn another one, even if you have got the resources. Right, then back up a touch, line up. That was short. And we've got a... damn it, that gunship's noticed us. This could be messy. Very quickly patch this up. Hope I can... Oh, God. Yeah, right. Bad. Oh, right. There was a Liberator as well. Happy, happy days. Okay, so much for bringing a tank to the fight. Grab the heavy assault. We'll do this the old school way with a rocket launcher. Now then, the armor is there. Adjust for range of touch and go. Is that an engineer behind him? Yes, I suspect it might. Let's see if we can get a shot. Pitch behind, see if the blast will take him out. And I think I got the range on that, so... Yeah, well, the tank is leaving, so I'll take that as a bonus anyway. Now, running a little short on ammo, so let's go grab a restock. Back into the spawn point, try and ignore the explosions because they've worked out where they're spawning from. Engineer for the moment, with a bit of luck, get some ammo packs down just like the other guys, except that we appear to have run out of things to shoot. Fine, repair the max instead. Although, why I'm bothering, I do not know. Of course, he could just rearm and reload, and that would patch him up regardless, but... Okay, can we wait still long enough for me to repair the loop? It's interesting to note that... Is that even working? That doesn't seem to be doing anything. I'm getting points for the credit, but his health bar's not shifting. And, oh, there we go. Is this just me failing at repairs? Yes, quite possibly. Okay, now, you've got an energy repairing you, if I can keep the range. Range on the repair gun is justifiably a little short. Back to the spawn beacon. Okay, there we go. Yes, the max is constantly moving, ladies and gentlemen. It could be a pain in the neck trying to simultaneously repair him and stay off the line. So where is that coming from? Who knows? Right, well, repairing's not really a great deal. Quickly grab a resupply. And how are we doing? Missed an opportunity there. There was a heavy assault there. Should have dumped the ammo pack for him. Never mind. Grab the rocket launcher again. Right. And hello, sailor! Or rather, hello, tyrannical scum. Must remember that I am a loyal new conglomerate soldier. On this server, I have always been a loyal new conglomerate soldier. Oceania has always been at war with Eurasia. Right, the noise appears to have stopped. This is either very good or very, very bad. Let's see. They appear to have given up and gone home. Interesting. Very, very interesting. Except not really, because you're not really watching this for the scenery, are you? You're watching it to make me make a fool of myself. So, let's jump to something more interesting. The situation 15 minutes in was marginally less bent than it was right at the start. As you can see, we're no longer completely threatened of being pushed right back to the gate. However, the Zervan main spawn area is still a principal hotspot. For that matter, the entire Zervan amp station was a principal hotspot for some time ahead, because this was the key junction in what was left of our terrain. If we lost this, then we were basically falling back to the gate, and were trying to scramble whatever territory we could back while the hippies and the tyrants fought each other. And as you can see, the situation at Zervan was basically the enemy at the walls and making rather a mess. half the turret grid was offline, just to make this interesting, and that's one of ours. Now, let's get this turret back online, see if we can use it to help the situation. And is that a... Yes, it is. Sneaky little son, I see you. Unfortunately, he saw me. I don't think I even hit him either. Ugh. Failed, failed, failed. And I don't care what people are saying about the Spectre. If you can double tap effectively with it, it's a very nasty piece of kit. Purely because it doesn't have, or at least doesn't seem to have, much in the way of
recoil. The shield control generator has been destroyed.
Yes. This is the way of things at Zervan, ladies and gentlemen. There are There are three shield generators dotted around the base that control the perimeter defences. An attacker has to take all three to drop the perimeter and allow their own armour into the base. However, obviously every defender knows that, so the moment the computer announces that shield generators are going down, you can expect an engineer swarm to start coming out and trying to repair them. And of course the generator is handily marked with that little broken shield icon and a spanner, just in case you really didn't get one. Now that's so handy. Come on. Oh god, this is going to shoot straight. Take some cover, quick.
The shield control generator has been destroyed.
Yeah, and by my reckoning...
The shield control generator is back online.
Okay, so we had lost shields just for a second. We got them back. Now then, where's this second? Okay, he's dead, so let's get this first generator coming back up. As with spawn control nodes, this takes a fair while to repair, deliberately so. There's not much point trying to break it down if you're an attacker, if it's just going to be fixed by one guy in a few taps with a wrench. Orphan, that's a good solid slap in the prayer to the machine god if you're a Vanu. So unfortunately...
A shield control generator.
And we also have this bug that if it comes to the active state, then it temporarily stops you from repairing as it switches entity. Funny thing is, it now looks worse than it does when it's wrecked. However, there we go. So, shield is firmly back up for the moment. Now then, that generator's good. We've got a galaxy there as a backup spawn point.
The shield control generator is back online.
And I think that is all three shield generators online, so the Vanu aren't going to be getting in for a moment. Unless, of course, they just fly a galaxy overhead and land on one of the key points and drop dead. Ass. Yeah. The downer to engineering, if you go head-to-head with a guy with a gun twice your size and personal deflector shields, you will probably lose. Fortunately, we have the galaxy, so it's not too much of an issue if we lose the spawn node. Galaxies in the defensive role are very, very powerful because you can just touch one down in the base, hide it behind the walls, and unless they can get high ground overlooking the walls, they're going to have a real troublesome time getting rid of that. Of course, the same thing goes the other way now. Somebody has just died. So, where did that happen? More to the point, where is the Vanu? One thing about the Zervan Amp Station is that there is an unshielded entrance to the base on the southwest corner, which you can actually see there just for a second. Go over the ledge, the particle field can take it. And let's see if we can get a couple of these turrets fixed up. If we can get the wall defences back online, just jump there to trip the bit. There we go. Right, give him a hand, not that he needs it. That turret's good. Take the accelerator pad. Actually, no, because I need that turret next. Boop. Again, the shields take most of the hit. You can fall quite a long way in this game. And of course, if you're jumping out of the galaxy, you can fall as far as you like. So 1 kilometer max drops are entirely viable. Right, let's see if that sniper shoots me this time. Right. Okay, map's not great, but at least we've isolated off that Terran assault. And there is a Vanu galaxy in the right side of the screen. Come on, how long to get this turret fixed? I really, really need some AAA right now. Come on, come on, come on. Why did this not restore itself at 50% like everything else? There we go. Sod. Well, we might have an angle from here. Yep, we do. Perfect. There we go. And of course, turrets being turrets. This is about to blow the heat on me. Yep. And not that it really matters because the Vanu has thought better of it. Run away, little hippie. Run away. Yes. Another one touched down there. And I think we've got a couple of hostiles working on the base, but the AAA gun's not going to do that much to them. Quick reply to Far Searcher, who is part of my outfit. Cutthroats, by the way, if you're NC and over on EU Beta 1, by all means, please join us. The more the merrier. Alright, let's see if there's anybody else to kill. I think we may be running out of targets here. Happy, happy days. Aha! No, we aren't. Come on, there we go. Good little hippie. Decides you don't want to stand out in the open. Aha, galaxy! Die, 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 die. Whoops, sorry. Die, die, die. Ugh. One annoyance about the battlements in this station is that it can be very, very awkward to try and get a proper track with the AAA. Now, they are trying to get an outfit squad going, but as you can see, I have this problem that there is no request to join squad option. Little awkward, but let's track this guy while we're here. Well, he's smoking, which I am told is bad for your health, and thank you. Good night. See if we can get the range. No, didn't really have it there. Alright, what else do we have? No, that's one of ours. Oh, God. Yeah. You have to get very good at recognising outlines in this game, because if you don't, you're going to make IFF mistakes, particularly if you can't make out colours. And again, I repeat my complaint about the yellow HUD that the NC have. Can we get that changed to a fairly neon blue? It would be nice to have something a little more distinct, particularly against desert terrain. Right, now then. Can I get angle on him? Don't think I've got the effective range. Nope, he's gone. Okay, so much for their air assault. Oh, no, no, no. Galaxy trying for the next facility over. Unfortunately for you, I have got range. And I'm about to overheat the gun if I'm not careful. Temperature gauge, bottom center of the screen, an important thing to watch, ladies and gentlemen. Just as the hit indicator, aha, there we go, so that's the range. Bang, 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 and overheat. Now, it's an annoyingly long time to unjam if you overheat these turrets, and he's gone. So that's that temporarily diffused. Right, I think we have run out of targets. Is that Sundra one of theirs? Can't tell. This is the problem with... Oh great, now I hit him after 5 seconds of straight fire and it was one of ours. Sorry mate, I think the paint can take it. Right. Mag Rider coming down the hill. AAA accuracy and viability against ground targets absolutely stink, so let's go find some. If I can find the anti-tank turret, that will give us a few extra options. And that was another bit of a fail, of course. Purple goes up, yellow goes down, and that is what you shall remember at all times. Right, now then, is this on my list? It is, but it's anti-infantry. Not that it matters, because looky here. And ye gods, this personal listing absolutely stinks. And it overheats, so you have to wonder if that turret, or at least that infantry turret, doesn't need a bit of a boost. Because as anti-infantry goes, well, you just witnessed it there. I mean, the sight's dodgy, but I'm getting more damage out of my carbine. than I am out of a double machine gun turret. Oh, and it's been wrecked anyway. I suppose I could try to repair it. This will probably end badly, because of course everyone's going to see that tank is shooting at me. This is not wise. This is a bad place to be. This is a very bad place. Now, try and get the shots there. And okay, duck. Right, can I get the flank from here? I think there is an overhang on the wall, so I may not have the line. No, I don't. Has he gone to the next one? Again, that overhang makes it a little awkward to judge, and I don't really want to win with that tanker either. I've got nothing that can make a dent in his hide. Problem is that infantry squad is almost certainly working its way to our back door, and a couple of maxes running round our shield generators would be a very bad thing. Right, there you are. Yeah. Controlled fire, ladies and gentlemen. New con weapons do have a bit of recoil, and well, I got him, I think. Now, is there an ammo pack I can liberate? No, can I destroy it? No. Can that destroy me? You bet. That wasn't even a direct hit, as far as I can tell. Either way, it's made quite a large hole. So, back to the galaxy. Stairs an engineer for the moment, since those turrets
are... A shield control generator has been destroyed.
Yeah, I should probably have called out that max unit working its way around. And hey guys, how are you? How are you doing? This is really, really bad. Heavy assault, heavy assault, heavy assault. Bad, bad, bad timing. Don't really need to be trying to do that when getting shot at. Now then, rocket launcher. Pop. Missed. And oh dear. That's bad.
A shield control generator is back online.
Done. I think I'm aiming too low here. Either that or I'm putting the rocket clean between his legs. Let's try again. Where have you gone? There we go. And thank you! Took long enough. Probably should be aiming a bit higher there. Centre mass when dealing with maxes. Don't try anything fancy. Right, now. I think we have dealt with this a lot. As I said, I should really have called it in on the text using slash zone. At least I think it's slash zone. It may be slash zovrol. Who knows? Either way, there's a spawn beacon off there, Vanu indicator, so I probably ought to try to get rid of that. But let's get back on the walls for a sec. I've still got a couple of rockets left. Hopefully, I can get rid of some of our problems. At least I would if I could see them before they see me. Fail at watching the back. Indeed. Alright, back we go again. Fortunately, we've still got the main spawn room. That has its own little shield generator protecting it, along with the central area, so it's fairly hard to shut down spawning at server. You really need to try. This particular base actually would...
The shield control generator has been destroyed.
God damn it. As I was saying, this particular base really would reward a good stealth and sabotage squad breaking in, even if just prior to a galaxy drop. Certainly, you can forget armor, except as a pin the walls force unless you take down the shields, so that, by and large, dictates an attack strategy. You either infantry it all the way, or you airdrop. However, if we can keep the shields going for the moment, Okay, that's a novel place to park.
The shield control generator is back online.
Yay, go-go engineers! And... oh, sod. Whoa! Okay, that's a nasty little nest they've got there. Deflector shields, although I don't want to be standing there for too long. So, let's see if... these shields are friendly, so I can step straight through them, but they'll block fire. So, if I get this right, I can pull the rocket launcher, take a couple of steps through the shield after lining up my shot. Bang! And we hit the medic! Excellent! Remember, Geneva Conventions do not apply here. Get the medics. and some lighter socks. Sorry, that may have been too close. I don't think it was, but we should be okay. I didn't get a friendly fire blip, but another damn beacon which I'm going to have to kill off. However, it's just fun to pop rockets into their areas. Now then, rocket into him. Let's see if that persuades him to abandon his firing position. Yes, it did. So, rocket there. Ah, didn't quite work, but I think it persuades him to dodge the turret, and that's us out of rockets. Now, can I get an angle on this beacon?
A shield control
generator. Nope, it was livening his day up.
A shield control generator.
Grenade, I think. No, bad angle, that's going to deflect off the. Yeah. Right, and yet again, fail. Purple is up, purple is up, purple is up. Right, that looked like a hostile heart pod. And hello there! Liberation, it's for everybody. Whether you want it in 7.62, 5.56, or 0.45, we cater to all comers. Right, hi. Bye. Okay, jump pads again. I really need to go find some ammo. I also need to shut down some of these spawn beacons, but that one's been taken out regardless. Let's just take a quick way down. Fail at navigating terrain, and right. Where are you? Can I get a shot? Nope, iron sights on this thing are a little too awkward. Reload as we go. I'm gonna have to try and find this before he decides to wreck another generator. Fortunately, there is the handy red arrow of doom. Or prey sight, depending on how you take these things. Right, let's go. Come on. Hi there! Have you heard the good news of liberation? Well, you have now. Right, how are we doing? There should be a rearm point somewhere around here. That generator's being repaired. So we'll dive into A. Yes, we have lost the inner deflector shield. That is bad. I'm surprised. I also thought that generator powered the internal shields.
A shield control generator has been destroyed.
But looking at it, of course, it's fairly obvious that it won't because it's inside the shields. That would be a sensible design. It would also be proof against just about anything, so sensible design is not permitted within the planet-side universe. Right, let's carry on. I really, really need to find a rearm point at this stage. Of course, it'd probably help if I didn't run straight past the spawn building. Twice, I fail at priorities. Okay, so how are we going to do this? Derby derby der. Okay, I suppose we could grab a tank, mix things up a bit. Yes, let's do that. Give these hippies, these degenerates, a dose of good old-fashioned heavy metal. Don't have the resources for the Vanguard after that little escapade earlier, so we'll grab the lightweight turbo lightning instead. I'm also not sure what kind of gun this has. It's got a 5-round auto, I think, but the damage appears to be absolute sod-all. Okay, hello there! Bam, 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 bam! See what I mean about sodding damage?
Come on.
Okay. Well, you are avenged. And I'm about to die horribly if I don't get out of sight of that random tank. Very, very quickly. Right, let's try to flank this guy because that's the only way this is going to work. I really should have taken an engineering kit. Can't repair this thing. It's going to die with the next decent hit. However, the van was able to pick it back. Hi there! Yeah, I think I missed with 4 out of 5 hits. And as I said, one decent hit generally does the job. Only 4% damage with a super. So hang on, what got the kill? Because I was at more than 4% there. Anyway, right, engineer learns the lesson. Of course, I now can't get a tank for a while between cooldown timers and lack of resources. And while I quickly sum up to the outfit leaders just why we're having fun at Zervrol, or rather Zervan, I can't can't even get the name right. I fail at navigation again. Right then, let us see where we stand. Okay, so there, we need a couple of shield generators back online. Racking up commendations is a reasonable clip, but I've got 10, so I can probably afford a decent gun sight for this carbine if I've ever got half of mine to actually remember to spend some points. Okay, head over to this shield generator. I think if we can get that online, where is that? Oh, there you are.
Has been
20 rounds, no hits, and probably wasted a grenade into the bargain. Happy, happy days. At least I don't have to pay for ammunition, and that was one of our heart pods arriving. Looks like it was by instant action. Oh no, we do actually have a beacon down, which is good. Okay, right now. He is probably going to follow me, so wait for a sec. Maybe he will, maybe he won't. Unfortunately, I can't hide behind the console while I'm repairing this because of the limited range of guns, so start the slow, slow process of getting this generator back online. Unfortunately, I am not Starfleet. I cannot turn rocks into replicate. Oh god! Rifle, damn it. Oh well, at least we got some of the repair done, but he'll be able to wreck it just as quickly. Yes. Should really have had a door blocker of some kind. Actually, no, what I should have had is a squad mate. Yes. First and most fundamental lesson of Planetside 2, ladies and gentlemen. Oh lord, they've got a galaxy on one of the pads. Fine, grabs the Max. I think if we load this up with double Falcon, let's just hope this does some damage. Right. Kentucky Windage, you bounce first with the solar panels. I laugh at your machine guns. Take a reload and just pop, pop, pop. Slow fire, but I can't actually tell how much damage it's doing. And, okay, I may laugh at your machine guns, but I don't laugh at your anti-tank weapons.
Has been destroyed.
And we're losing shield.
A shield control generator is back online.
Right, the shield generator tag, ladies and gentlemen. Engineers, of course, get turrets. And generally the idea about that is you can defend fixed locations now. Can I get an angle on that galaxy with the AAA turrets? Because at the moment, let's face it, trying to do it with infantry weapons, even maxes, is basically a waste of time now. Do I have the angle? Oh, gods. Solar panels, or at least whatever those pointy things are. They are most irritating. Can we please get rid of them? It would be nice to be able to turn the AA weapons inside to deal with irritating galaxies. Although I think somebody else dealt with it anyway. Let's just take the jump pads around and see what the situation is. Yeah, I think we're clear. But that was a hostile heart pad landing. Now then, where did he go? Where did he go? Where did he go? We've got a stealthy. Aha! Nice try! Should have shot me a third time, but nice try. Okay. Pop. Right, shields are coming back up. Health is really, really broken. And the Terrans have joined in. Oh, happy, happy days. Even if I didn't have enough trouble already. Right. Keep doing the laps of the gates. Base shields are back online, so we still can't get deflectors in. Now, let's see if we can persuade that tank to move. Well, we missed, but I think it was because he moved, so we'll call that a success. Right. Okay, I think things are stabilizing here a little. Yes, yes, the noise is definitely quieter than it was. Of course, what that meant was that I just failed as hard at tactical analysis as I did at everything else in this game, because the generator tag carried on for another 15 minutes. After that, Cutthroats got a squad together, and we decided to change the rules of the game a little by paying our neighbours a nice, leisurely visit, complete with tea and biscuits and high-explosive, fiery liberation death. The map was starting to look a little dicey again, as you can see. Zervan was in danger of being cut off, particularly if we lost the gravel pass, which was a three-way fight. The only good news was that the Vanu and the Terrans were shooting at each other just as much as they were shooting at us, which I suspect may have actually slowed both sides' assault down a little bit. However, first stop was the Mazer comm station, just a quick hop by Galaxy and a few scratches on the paint. Speaking of scratches on the paint, obviously, the Galaxy was repaired first while it was soaking in bullets for the rest of us. And with that done, switch to heavy assault and let's go see if we can get some terrain up. Now, the deflector shield animation for assaults has changed somewhat. Rocket launcher in just to help persuade people to duck. Namely, if you have the force field up and you are attempting to aim down the sight, it basically becomes impossible. There is so much visual distortion that it just can't be done. However, we need the long range options here, so yeah. We need to do some sniping. Pow, bolt drive. Unfortunately, that was a center mass shot. Didn't really have the angle for a second, and because the new con sniper rifle is a bolt action with a magazine, you can't just send a follow-up shot, and you actually have to unzoom, bolt, and rezoom, which costs you on fire. The trade-off, of course, is that you get more damage. Now then, come on, just stick your head out. Thank you, Zeodus. Right. He's slowly pinned behind those crates. I will fail at crossing a 1-foot-tall obstacle. Why I bother to cloak, I do not know. It's absolutely worthless when you're at a flat sprint. And our galaxies move up and parking. Yeah. Galaxies are tough. Unfortunately, infiltrators aren't. So I failed at dodging bullets and indeed breathing. Combat medics. Unfortunately, while the Geneva Conventions may not apply, that also means they're allowed to carry guns. Highly irritating. Bit of a wait for the Galaxy to redeploy. There we go. Heavy assault again. And yeah, the Galaxy is right outside their spawn point, so this got a touch awkward. Hello, Mr. Max. Goodbye, Mr. Max. Rocket launcher in the face. Yes. Not exactly a standard anti-personnel option, but it works if you're careful not to stand in front of an irritated Max with two high explosive grenade launchers. Fortunately, they hadn't killed the Galaxy at this point, so it was just quick enough to respawn in.
Coming out of the back of support. I shouldn't have said that.
There we go.
I need help repairing.
Right. And since he was up there, I suppose we should really try to flank that. Right. Cap point is coming around to our way of thinking. There we go. So if we can just rack up the influence markers and secure this, we can pull a good deal of the heat off our assault. Kindly die, thank you. Something else tonight, so I need to get a reflex sight for the machine gun on this chap. Alright, Max is gone. And well, technically, Red Light was dead before I fired that rocket, but hey, it's planet side. Death is only temporary, and very definitely not an excuse. Okay, quick reload at the Galaxy.
Back to the chopper, guys.
The noise has pretty much stopped, so switch back to engineer. Actually, did I need to do that? No, I wanted combat medic instead. Right. Turret up. As you can see, it's now the Terrans who are encircled. And this was pretty much the way of things for the next half hour or so. We would carry on hopping from station to station, recapping and generally getting into fights.
Oh,
And if the occasional Terran Galaxy showed up, well, our AAA did dispose of it. Matters got considerably hairier, however, at the Galaxy Solar Plant when the Terrans finally caught on to what we were doing and started doing it as well. We were dealing with a few isolated infantry on the northwest side of the solar plant when suddenly there was a small distraction behind me. It turns out that the Terrans have very quiet galaxies and very large guns. So we now had a galaxy on our roof, which caused a few little difficulties. Naturally, we had the spawn beacon handy, so I was able to heart straight back in. Unfortunately, it turns out that galaxy armor is proof against a heart pod being dropped on it from low orbit. Like so. It also turns out that standing in front of a galaxy's turret at point-blank range is a really, really bad thing to do, even if the galaxy gun can't shoot straight. When you've practically jammed your groin into the barrel, it really doesn't matter. And then we lost the spawn control room, so it became a little trickier. Alright, rocket into that galaxy, just see if we can take it out and deny them their advantage. Looks like we might have the option. There it goes. Unfortunately, they've got a spawn beacon up, so I suppose we'd better go and take that out and make sure they aren't getting that last wave of reinforcement. Oh yeah, and they've almost captured it. And what the hell is shooting me? Right, he's going to go right flank. And it would be so nice if I could shoot properly. Okay, that leaves me with a bit of a problem, because we have no galaxy, we have no spawn beacons. Well, we do, but I'm on a minute and a half cooldown. And we have no spawn controller, so I can't just spawn in. Which left the palisade 563 meters away. Little awkward. Now, as it turned out, the palisade had its own problems. The Terrans were just making a nuisance of themselves there as well. Spray painting graffiti and just running away. You know what it is, red paint ought to be a restricted substance. At least on Auraxis. Fortunately, it was easily dealt with. We had such a dominating influence, a 3-to-1 advantage, that all we had to do was grab the capture point back, which was a fairly simple matter. And then the defense counter ticked up fairly quickly. It also helped that somebody else had happily killed off whichever Terran was causing the problem in the first place. Little graffiti artist that he was, lackey of a tyrannical regime. But if you can see the influence bar on the left and just see how fast that went up once we had it compared to how fast the Terrans was crawling up, you can see how much of a difference it makes when you have significant influence in a hex. Alright, so that's that dealt with. So the real priority has to be getting back to the fight. Of course, now I could have taken a jump pack, but that was so the best options were really the quad bikes, since I couldn't find a tank terminal. Now, there we go. The Flash has headlights, which is great. It lights you up, and it also lights up a here I am, please shoot me beacon. And let's face it, the night is good enough that you can more or less see where you're going regardless, so we'll just lose the headlights in good military fashion. Now, we could take the roads, but those are for losers. So, now, how sharp is this cliff? Well, once I get to the bottom, it should be fairly easy to go. If I take one of the gullies, this should go just fine. Oh, God! Okay, so I landed and then I died? Okay, right. We're not going to be using quad bikes for a bit, I think. Gonna be a little awkward. We could take the rope, we'd have to go the long way round over that bridge, find a way down, or just find a less suicidal gully. So, rather than that, can I get something at Zervan? I think so, but I think I may have to go all the way back to the warp gate to get a replacement galaxy. So, let's just see what I can get. Now, there was a way up there. Is that... That's one of our galaxies, but I don't know whether it was spawned there or whether it's just been parked up. I have a suspicion it's only been parked up and then I'm wasting my time trying to get this going. And as it turns out, I was wasting my time because you can indeed only get galaxies from the warp gate, which makes a certain amount of sense. The warp gates are meant to be safe havens, secure zones that you can use to quietly organise and coordinate squads and generally catch your breath. It would be much nicer as a consequence if weapons were disabled within them so you didn't have to worry about jokers. Let's be polite about this. Deciding to go trigger happy on their own side. If you want to shoot us, go and join your tyrannical masters or sign up with the hippies, but at least have the decency to spray your armor the right colors. Don't disgrace the blue and yellow, ladies and gentlemen. Map itself was looking considerably healthier at this point, several hours on. We were no longer quite as broken as we were. You can't keep the forces of liberty down. Unfortunately, it took a while to get the galaxy back to the galaxy solar plant. I wonder if those are connected. And when I did eventually arrive, passing over the Mesa comm station as I did... Actually, no, that was the palace, wasn't it? I got one entry and lost my back. It turned out everybody else has had much the same idea, because there were four galaxies of varying types dotted around, and trying to get a landing site turned out to be a little tricky. Because, as you can tell from that blam 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 going on, and the rapid way my health bar is deteriorating, the Terrans had not only brought a couple of mozzies, they'd brought a flak tank as well. So this does not end well, despite an attempt to get down to another zone and land. Yeah, we need more than medics. We really, really do. However, still lacking a convenient spawn point any nearer than the palisade, it was probably a bad idea on my part to head back to the warp gate and try and get a reaver in an effort to clear out the air a little. Because I only have the baseline Reaver, we don't have joystick support, and I find mouse flying to be a matter of utter fail. If you haven't noticed a theme to this video, then you may have picked up a hint now and again, even so. However, it seemed like a good idea at the time. What can I say? So many of my mistakes have that justification attached. Now, the Reaver's handling is much, much nicer, as you might expect. Single-seat fighter analog. Gunship is perhaps the wrong word, since that title is taken more by the Liberator. And why the Terrans call it that, I do not know. They presumably intend to insult liberty itself by referring to it in their arsenal of tyranny. Gratuitous rolling. What can I say? Right, afterburner's very, very handy, essentially a limited sprint mode for the jet. Got back to the galaxy plant in double time, only to discover that not only can I not shoot straight in an aircraft any more than I can on the ground, I'm a bit okay in a tank, but that usually has the luxury of lining up time. Turns out all the aircraft had gone. Little sods that they were, spoiling my party. The map was still healthy. That can shift very rapidly. Shouldn't have been looking at it over our hot circles, because it turns out that black tank is still there. If you miss that shot at the mozzie, loop back, find myself in the flak tank envelope, and boom. Yeah, didn't even get to the ground before that sky guard blew me away. Ladies and gentlemen, that has been the tale of fail for the 13th and 14th of September. I'll see you next time.